Oh. partir, quale suono sovie?
Thank you. Thank you. Oh! Oh,
Oh!
Oh,
Thank you.
et peut-être un outrage. Mathilde, mais pas indiscret, ont osé jusqu'à vous se frayer un passage. Mathilde effrayée après de me connaître, j'ose le dire avec un noble regret, vous le ciel m'avait fait naître d'un préjugé fatal. J'ai mesuré le cœur, il s'élève entre nous de toute sa puissance. Je puis le respecter, mais c'est en votre absence. Mathilde, ordonnez-moi de fuir loin de vos yeux, d'abandonner ma patrie et mon père. Allez-moi sur la terre étrangère, de choisir pour ta main des ports inhabités, prononcer sur mon sort. Dites un mot.
Thank you. Something like 400 pages of new discovered music, you know. He really made clear that the one we are playing tonight in Amsterdam is really the official version that Rossini himself not only attended, but he was during rehearsals. Therefore, the one he really wanted to hear to start with. Therefore, I think it's a great privilege to have this phenomenal new printed edition of the critical score, which provide all the elements to be as close as possible to the original performance. For instance, the beginning of the famous aria of Guillaume, Sois Immobile, is clearly written that Rossini wanted all the celli to play the solo line and not, as always, one solo cello. And that's the way it was done by the time in Paris. And for instance, in the recitativi, funny enough, in this original version, the recitative of the fourth act are much, much severely reduced, which dramaturgically work much better. If you think we play now 80 minutes of music with these two acts, absolutely complete, uncutted version, but still, I mean, rich of so much music, so much to expose everybody. I mean, not only the soloists, which is one of the reasons why it's so seldom performed. You need the tenor, which can use the top C register like just talking, you know, as well as you need a virtuoso soprano. You need a great baritone role to carry the whole evening, the role of Guillaume. And not last but not least, the orchestra, which has an incredible nightmare of billiards of semiquavers to play. And the chorus, of course, very exposed as well. So it's very challenging, but very risky. It's a real risk you take every time to perform William Tell, but I think it's worth it.
All together. Don't be brutalizing the sound. Don't force. You're forcing the sound. Fortissimo from the collectivity. Don't force. Again, three out of four. Sound. It's a little bit slow. It's a bit slow. It's a bit slow. Get boring otherwise. It gets sloppy. A fraction faster. Yes, it's too slow. Again, please. A fraction faster. Three befores, thank you. We need to get used to it. Three matter four, again. Okay. That's the tempo.
Het is niet alleen vreemd dat een Italiaans componist als Rossini een opera schrijft in de Franse taal, maar het is natuurlijk ook raar dat een Italiaans dirigent als Chailly de Franse versie verkiest boven de Italiaanse.
Yeah, he was of course very affected by then by the world of French music in Paris, especially the fight against Meyerbeer provoked very much his irritation all the time. So he wanted also to prove his capacity and his understanding of the French language. And also, don't forget that the Paris Opera at the time was necessary to perform it in the French language with the addition of ballet music. That's what also Verdi did with Don Carlos, Trovatore, etc., Vespri Siciliani. But I have a feeling that the rhythmical side of the language in the French text is the most logical and natural, even on Italian music of Rossini, than the translated version. Don't forget, I performed the Italian version in the late 70s, when I was really a very, very young guy.
And you recorded it.
And also, yes. And therefore, I know exactly the differences. And I found the whole contest of style of playing, even, in the orchestra, in spite of being an Italian mood piece, there is a requirement of a much more French dynamic range, for instance, than with the Italian music. It needs much more shading than normally Italian operas, even early Rossini's. It's a different kind of approach with Rossini sound, as it is different when you perform the religious Rossini, like the Stabat Mater or the Messa Solenne. It requires a different approach. Therefore, it's extremely challenging also for the orchestra.
Four notes. One. Once more, please. From bar. Oh, the same, please. Noch in care, also, please. Dieselbe. Thank you.
Alla gloire a vous-même. arriva monorrea. De chant, de cri.
Che star se mai?
Le jour, le rota, se por fait.
Hélas! Une fête de guerrière. Se chante, le soleil s'apprête.
Oh!
Oh. vient. Le voleur à ce bruit soudain s'enfuit. Mon défenseur s'approche, alors calmez votre frayeur. Je ne vous quitte pas, prenez mon bras. Non, non, monsieur, seul j'irai. Lancez l'embras, bon gré, mal gré. Jusqu'en votre logis, je veux vous escorter. Non, non, assez de me presser. Calmez-vous, je vais vous laisser. Mais un baiser, un seul baiser, comment le refuser? Un baiser que le veut, il en prie deux. Et pendant ce moment, oh mon Dieu, disais-je en tremblant, sauve l'honneur du couvent. Mais je suis grâce au ciel, à l'abri de l'orage. Se fit réduit, et je ne sais pourtant quelle fatale image jusqu'au pied du Saint-Dieu. Devant toi, mon pouvoir s'abaisse. Comment